First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh. Second thing, second, don't you tell me what you think that I can be. I'm the one at the sail, I'm the master of my sea. Oh, ooh, the master of my sea. Oh, ooh. I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me, feeling me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
Welcome, Mixer. How you guys doing? Firefly, Epi. I'm sure Fallen's in there. I have random voice coming out of all sorts of places. Awesome setup. We are back now, kind of back to our full-time schedule. Tomorrow is a travel day. There'll probably be no early morning stream. Gonna hopefully get the 4 p.m. going. If you are new here, however, there's a little bit new setups going on. If you are new here, there's a number of ways that you can go ahead and, hey, Spiritus, number of ways you guys can go ahead and get involved. We already have put out the tweet. You can follow us on Twitter, retweet at 10 retweets. Every player on the board will get advantage, one advantage each to use. At 20, everyone gets an extra 20, 30, and then we start doing straw polls, see what you guys want to, you know, help support the party with. That being said, you can also donate down below. Donate, you can give your favorite player a magical item, healing potions, all sorts of different things there. Or you can go over to our Patreon and support the stream and the server itself. The World of Pharrell is a Discord server in which we have a 24/7 West Marches game that plays. We have most of our one-shots here. There are a number that either are just on Discord or non-streamed events. Like if I'm not DMing or playing, Epi or Craig or Firefly, which is not in school, we'll run a game and it might not get streamed. If I'm around and generally free, I'll try and stream it so we have recordings of it. But that is basically how this all operates. Made a number of other friends in the Mixer community while we've been sick. This month's kind of been a little bit tough, but yeah, stuck it out and we're back to it. So, without further ado, let's meet our party for today. Hello, party.
Hello, Seth.
Hello.
So, we have a number of returning players. We have people like Tree, who's playing Bran. We have Fallen, who's playing Riker. Josh is playing James. He's got a thing with J names. I don't know what it is, man. You got Epi, who's playing Sam. But we do have a new player with us today. Hi, Biohazard Pirate.
Hey, how's it going?
So why don't you tell us a little bit about Wrath?
Wrath? Well, he's a purple tiefling, vibrant green eyes. He spent most of his time as a soldier in Thornreach. Got a family there, wife and a beautiful daughter, to potentially find a better way to make a bit of coin for providing for that family. So,
and being a Yetirian native, hates dragons with a passion.
Yes.
High fives.
High five.
I mean, guys, there's some news, I gotta tell you. Just happened. You already have 10 retweets, so every one of you start with an advantage.
Nice.
Right off the bat. They're doing it hard today. They're supporting you guys well. So, all of you guys have gathered inside the Guild Hall in the Enclave of Valor. As you guys are sitting around and kind of discussing the bounty, I believe it has been Riker who has done the most kind of research and putting together of this, if I'm not mistaken.
For the most part, besides the fact that Brienne is job-wise connected to the whole idea of hunting dragons.
Mooney Mario, thank you for the follow and welcome to the adventure. You guys all kind of are around inside this. You know, the camera kind of pans through the doors. You guys are down at the novice lounge, and you know, you guys are looking at the map. So to give you kind of the layout, Sheraton is in more of the middle western part of Lyca. It's separated by one of our old adventuring locations, Cortia, by a forest known as the Zon Woods. Sam and James do know that an old adventurer, someone that does hang around the guild, known as Boggle, or Leoris, to those who don't know his nickname. That is the woods as a druid he is kind of tied to protect. Not as a home, but more a task he took on. And you haven't really heard anything from him about knowing this.
Riker knows about Boggle and has met him and interacted with him a little bit. He knows the general vicinity of where he's keeping guard. Yeah. Where he runs off to every now and then, but hadn't been able to get directly a hold of him to be able to ask more about the woodlands themselves. He knows not to use fire there.
Yeah, we'll not turn well with the druid if you burn down his forest. Just gonna let you all know that now. That's free knowledge.
Sam would let them know.
Well noted.
Some of you guys are new, but before we did the time schedule, we moved into the Age of Heroes. We were playing storylines of Cortia, and they had the pension for not even in one shots, like regular RP on the Discord that you've got yourself into, Wrath, here, to burn down the forest of Cortia multiple times. Cortia is the city of fire, according to most of the reports.
Everything changed the day Cortia attacked.
All right, Wrath, I do need you to do something for me because we have some people here in the chat that. That, you know, are our patrons, and they like supporting us. So what I need you to do for me is I need you to roll me a D100. If someone is calling in their Misfides on you, Firefly, I didn't get you your Misfides. I did get Craig. Who would you like to use yours on, Firefly, as you said something? You just have to tell me what you roll, because I'm on the other page.
Okay, roll 20 is being a little weird right now, so I'll do it through the Discord.
Okay, that works for me. I don't mind that. Good old bot number is... waits for the typing. A 39. All right, so you are currently having some trouble with things, so I will roll the common. You know, you look under your seat as you're sitting there, and goes to the list. Common magic items. You find a hat of vermin from Xanathar's Fallen. You're going to have to pull it up. I don't have the Xanathar's with me. If you can tell him what that does. You kind of find this weird-looking hat. Known as the Hat of Vermin. That is now a magical item that you own.
Neat.
It's in the lore, Sir Ogsar Grove. Are you using yours, Firefly? Because you haven't used yours yet this month either. So, we've had a lot of...
Hey, what do you know? I got it right on the book. I had it open to that page.
So, you can go ahead and just type it out. So we,
sure.
So, as you guys are all sitting there, what are the questions you guys are discussing? Is there anything that you guys need to do? I already sent you to run for potions.
Yes, because that was going to definitely be a necessity. Riker would have asked Ollie if there was any further information that she had in regards to Captain Taylor Torrent descriptions or anything like that.
Oh, I did put a name. You know that she kind of is more... She's a captain of the guard, according to Ellie. Not one that kind of gets her hands dirty. More kind of like the desk jockey. Got the promotions basically in dealing with like kind of just the guild and probably, you know, giving or, you know, passing orders along. She tells you that you're more likely to look for a guard station outside of the city, and a guard captain named Wilfer is probably going to have more information for you than going to find Taylor Turret.
Sam holds up a finger, looks towards the guildmaster's office and goes, Roland, is Bogle raising dragons in his forest?
The door slightly opens and looks right at you, Sam, Roland's standing there, and goes, if he is, kill them if they're chromatic. Please, dear God.
Okay.
He looks down and yells, Crystal, if they're your pets, I'm sorry, and closes the door.
Well, while all this is happening, James is trying to remember if he would know anything, like, any more about the Woodlands than you've already told us. Aside because of his touring and being dragged along by a druid.
Alright. So, Wrath, we're actually going to double up. Roll me another D100.
Oh, okay.
And what was... my voice is a little low compared to the others. How about now? Maybe if I move the mic a little bit closer. Is that better, Craig?
83.
An 83. So, you again, you're like, you're sitting on something, and you find a small pebble. Alright? As you pull it up, it kind of like bursts in light. And due to that roll, every player at the table, you now also have a natural 20. As you have a natural 20 to everyone. You're not taming a dragon.
Damn!
I already knew the lie.
Who would want a chromatic anyway?
Goes to find a dragon egg.
So did you guys hear me or?
Yep. Not
yes.
Okay. While all this was happening, James was just wondering if he, besides what you've already told us, if he knew anything more about the Woodlands because of his touring and being dragged along by a druid with his sister.
I mean, the Zaun Woodlands. You, based on your history, less about your travel. You know that, you know, they're a very expansive forest. It is considered an ancient forest. One of the ancient forests in the world. That being said, you were around there for, like, you know, the hags and stuff like that, so, where your sister was, so, you know, there's a good amount of knowledge which you've imparted, but other than, you hearing the stories that Moral once laid there and before they woke him up, and that was a black dragon, mind you. Not a lot. But somewhere out there is Azuri's hand crossbow and something of yours and, yeah, all sorts of things that were left behind somewhere. But that's basically what you know.
Yeah, okay. Thank you.
Obviously without any rolls or anything like that.
Could I roll something or no?
Try and roll me.
Nature?
Can I roll to see to see what kind of I don't know eating habits green dragons have?
Sure. I would consider that nature. Favorite prey too, right?
Favorite enemy.
James, yeah, yeah. The only other thing you know is there's like a pretty good being an older forest, there's a wildlife is pretty abundant in there. Being kind of a protected land, which druids themselves have, you know, not really allowed the cities or countries to expand into. There should be like a good amount of deer, elk, etc. That you'll come across. It's not, you know what I mean? There should be a good amount of wildlife.
Obviously, I would tell all this information to the party.
And Sam, food, pretty much.
Okay. That's, yeah, I figured as much.
Clever, tricky, based on your history. So, anything else before you guys head out?
Wrath would ask who the commanding officer of the party is. Like, who's in charge?
Points at Riker.
Looks to Riker.
He'll salute him.
Riker tips his hat.
Sam's giggling in the background.
James just looks at the fact that he's the only healer.
Sam's gonna rush up to Crystal and goes, do you have any toffees or anything you want to give Bogle in case we encounter him while we're there?
Crystal would look at you and like Bogle waves from inside.
Oh.
I don't know where Bogle actually is. But he's binding. I go bind. And he jumps out the window and runs off.
Damn it, Bogle.
Let's get ready to send Spartans a message and go, Bogle, go bind.
So, as you guys head out, she gives you a piece of toffee anyways, though, Sam, for visiting. And a hug. Because it's Crystal. So.
Sam comes back from eating a piece of toffee.
Alright. So as you guys head out of the Guild Hall, you start walking across the cobblestone streets of the Enclave of Valor, a small island, somewhere in the seas. Some people do actually know its location, but they've traveled by ship. And those of you that come by Teleportation Circle will go, I don't have no clue. It's basically an island that's not directly connected to any sort of landmass itself. Like it's not an outlying island on Azora or like or anything like that. It's kind of just an island in the middle of the ocean. Makes it kind of easy to be under no country's kind of grasp.
Sam turns around and says, I theorize this island is on the back of a giant turtle, just swimming around.
The turtle looks at you and says no. Puts that back in. No, I'm just kidding. So, you guys head into the teleportation circle. In there is Gavon, a dark-skinned individual covered in robes, who, for most of you, Wrath, you came via teleportation, right?
I have done the teleportation 3 times now.
Okay. So as you've come, he knows you as well and waves to all of you. Doesn't need to ask your name, he would have known you then. So, you know, he goes, where are you guys off to today?
We are headed toward Leica, west of Cortia to the Zone Woodlands.
You have a copy of Benny, right?
Yes.
Looks over. So would you like to be near Sheraton?
That would probably be the best idea. That way we can try to speak with the representative of the guards.
Okay. So, yeah, he builds you all up to step up onto the teleportation circle. As each of you do, he begins casting the teleportation spell. One by one, these glyphs carved into this large stone circular platform begin to burst with like a light blue arcane energy as it builds up, almost encompassing all of you. Your vision kind of fades from the ability to see outside, and there's that small popping sound. And you go from an inside temperature of nice to it's roughly about the same, you know, just about freezing temperature. But, you know, you guys would all have been dressed appropriately based on it's about the same at the island. So no need to check. It's not drastically colder or drastically warmer. Wrath, something that we had not discussed, but will come into play. Now, most of Yedria is very tropical and warm. You don't really see snow. Probably being on the island was your first Seeing of snow being that it is an island, you know, it's very light. As you kind of arrive out here in this outer teleportation circle outside of the city, you're about a quarter mile away is the way that Sheraton has theirs. There's, you know, about 2 foot of snow on the ground. You know, roads are obviously somewhat cleared, but it is it's definitely something different that you're encountering for the first time.
Mm-hmm.
Sam curses about the cold and pulls her bear hood up.
Hey, it's cold. Experience. Yeah, I forgot about that. Sam.
Cold didn't bother me.
The cold never bothered you anyway?
This is Quinn. If the bard starts singing that song, I will kill the bard. I don't care. I will walk away and leave the body lying there in the cold.
That's just cold. Wait, no, I'm not my sibling, dang it. I can't do this.
So, are you guys can see from where you are. You can see the walls of Sheraton about a quarter mile away. About, I would say, a couple hundred yards away from the city, there looks to be a smaller kind of guard outpost. Looks like it deals with the farms and travelers before they get up towards the city. So where are you guys all headed?
Looks to where Fearless Leader.
Well, you're all party members. You all have a voice.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Riker is not that kind of ruler.
Squints, sighs. You wanted to go talk to someone, right?
Figured that we would be able to go to speak competitive word that we would be able to versus whoever would be in charge of the situation with the dragons. Hopefully without causing a panic.
Then lead the way.
Riker will go forward to seek out somebody that they could ask directions from.
Yeah, I mean, you look either way on the road. And there's not a lot of foot traffic right now. I mean, you guys are coming, you know, which would be more, you would set out in the morning rather than at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. You know, not always, time doesn't always line up when one shots, right? So, very few. You do see a number of kids kind of playing in the snow, throwing snowballs back and forth, and generally being kids.
So, Sam, as they're walking, will look to James. Good, James, your brother's still your sister, or is it like your sister who's your brother?
World magic has ceased to function, if that's what you're asking.
Oh, that's great. So he's your brother again.
No, forever a woman. Sister.
Oh, how does Iris feel about that?
She doesn't mind it, as far as I can tell. Oh, you'd have to ask her personally. I don't. Anytime I've dabbled in those specific questions to her, she has gotten defensive.
She just pats him on the back. Rath, who are you?
I'm sorry. Just that.
Who was it that asked Rath a question?
Sam.
Sam. And what was the question?
Who are you? She. I notice a Yidrin pang to your accent. Me too.
Yes, I am from Thornreach, a soldier among their ranks. Pleasure to meet you, he'll hold out a purple tinted hand.
She'll shake it and be like, I'm a Wavering Blight, one of the guys that live up a mountain who hunt things.
You would recognize the name, Rath, not of your country. They're not Samal. They are Zulan, so they are directly to the south. While they get along, there is, you know, some tensions, as with all Yadrian politics. But, you know, they've never been in open conflict with one another.
And she looks at a strong, silent one and goes, Have we met?
Rain looks at him. Sam. And she looks very thoughtful. She goes, I think so.
Wasn't, like, in the tavern one night, drinking, you know? Because I would have totally made you breakfast. I just, sometimes I like to have lions.
Sam, roll me a history check. While you're not sure if you have drink or hit on Brienne, you do know that Craig and Firefly are hosting, so thank you for the host. So.
Oh. Yeah. Have we ever just... Riker! Good to see you. Thanks for inviting me.
Pleasure to invite you.
She just watched all of this in much confusion. Like, for you just watched Sam go from, like, five different conversations, not even lingering on any of them.
So, are you guys going to ask the children anything, or are you headed, where are you guys, which place are you going to?
I guess so I'm the witch.
Pushes the clown forward.
I'm not in the jester outfit anymore, dang it.
You're gonna... joking, because I am always the jester.
I do need a new token, I'm aware. I'll get to it one day.
I never said gesture, I said clown. Pushes you forward.
Everyone freaking calls him a clown anyway, okay? Anyway. Anyway.
A little kid looks at you, James. Why are you dressed like a jester?
I'm not.
Are you funny?
I'm not.
He's not really, no.
Anyway, I wanted to ask the party members how they all preferred the fight. Since range. Never met any of them before. One ranged?
In the back, ranged.
Okay, ranged.
I prefer to be up close and personal, but I also have some capabilities at range.
A jack of all trades, okay.
Better up front.
Okay, and then I'm just going to be the guy running back and forth healing all you. All right.
I also have some healing capabilities if it comes to be necessary.
Thank you. Really, I appreciate this so much.
Well, small you can't have your
freezes on his cheek.
Just happiness.
Sam was dear. Your makeup's running.
I'm not wearing makeup.
Oh, you're Rath, naturally you left here.
Rath will, like, since he's like seeing snow for probably one of the first times in a long time, he'll like pick up a bit with his tail and kind of lob it at one of the children. Just playfully.
Yeah, give me a dexterity check.
Alrighty.
See if you hit this kid.
Jan will have to do it.
You're one of those guys that has real 20 issues.
Yeah.
A six.
Currently, I had to restart my computer.
You miss wide as a kid, but like his eyes go big. One, he's probably never seen a tiefling before. You know, being he's probably a farm kid, not inside the city. But he's like, he points to all the other kids. What's your armor class? Or what's your dex bonus?
Is 16.
What's your dex bonus?
Oh, dex bonus is +2, I believe.
Okay. So you're a 12 target. So, yeah, all the kids, they just pop up. You're pelted with snow. They all laugh and wave towards you.
Rath will laugh heartily and wave to the kids.
Can I find a carrot, Sev?
You're looking for a cart?
No, a carrot.
Oh.
What?
It's winter. Go to a store.
Damn it.
That's so random. Can I have a
I know
carrot?
What he was going with. I know what he was trying to do. I do epi.
Oh, yeah, actually, yeah. I just figured it out.
So, are you guys going to ask the kids anything, or which restriction are you getting?
Like I said before, Riker would end up wanting to find out where they would be able to find the representative for Captain Taylor Torrent, preferably without causing a panic. Hello, sick kids, if any of them know where to find her. Hello there, children. I trust you're having a good day.
They're all laughing and pointing, and they just hit Wrath with Snow. And one of the younger boys walks up. Yep, this is my battalion, and he waves to all the kids, who that mock salute him.
Quite a suitable battalion you have here.
He looks to the end. And he goes, Tom though. Tom doesn't have any aim. See, Tom's the one guy that missed Wrath.
I resonate with this kid now at character level.
Ah, well, remember, you're only guessing, so be sure to improve his aim.
He looks over. But I keep telling him not to eat the yellow snow, and he keeps eating it.
Oh.
He's special.
Don't worry, Tom.
We'll get him extra care.
Tom's currently eating yellow snow with him. In the corner. He holds up a hand.
No. Don't worry, Tom. I know he'll argue.
I think he's your spirit animal, Josh.
Shush it. That's just cold, man.
Well, it is snow.
Snow, you went there.
The kid looks back over towards Tom and goes, yeah, our mom makes us play with him. Apparently his dad's a good trainer or something.
How old do these kids look?
Like, they're like 6 and 7.
Oh.
Not very old.
Sam raises an eyebrow, dad, uncle.
Shit. The kid just goes, oh.
I just realized I can do something. Sam takes out a plate and a whole bunch of cookies appears on it.
There you go, using those Christmas gift magic items. The kids all look at him. Is there's one bite taken out of each of them, as that was the plate. Like, they just shrug and eat them anyways.
Just that's always the shape, but they're tasty.
The kids are very, very impressive. So, Riker, you wanted to ask about the guard captain, correct?
Yes.
So, what do you actually say to them?
Whereabouts might we be able to find the office of Captain Taylor Torrent?
The kids blink. Who?
Captain Taylor?
They huddle up. Never heard of her.
Are you sure?
They all nod.
Riker, meanwhile, is rolling a...
She's a desk jockey. You think she ever came out to the farms to do goodwill? Oh, hell no.
Riker chuckles.
And the kids are completely honest with you, by the way.
Whereabout might the closest actual settlement be?
The settlement points to Sheraton. It's about a quarter mile. Still easy enough to see in the plains. And they point to... But if you're looking for a guard captain, they point, yeah, it's probably a couple hundred feet now from where the kids are playing. You see, like a basic kind of like a two-story with a watchtower built into it. Probably has like a courtyard open for some horses. Very minor, not going to stand up against a siege, but enough if it was just something. You know, like a little...
Just something small.
Yeah, it goes, well, there's guard captain Wilfer. He's up there. We sent him home packing earlier. We beat the guards. They all kind of puff their chests out a little bit.
With their snowballs?
You know it.
All right, keep up the good work. And Riker will withdraw one silver piece for each of the kids.
They all look. Their eyes go wide. They all take them. Tom looks at it and bites on it. He's seen his dad probably do it once. Well, yeah, the kid takes it away from him and goes, no, no, you don't eat this. No.
I was expecting him to stick it up his nose or something.
No. He says that, you know, you check for, you know, real coinage in the middle ages, you bite on it.
Yeah. Make sure
it wasn't fake. So yeah.
You probably heard on the way out anyway, Tom.
Terrence looks, alright, bye, mister, we're gonna go to the shop! And they just all start sprinting, because they're gonna buy, like, you know, hundreds of pieces worth of candy right now.
Damn straight. And Riker made sure that they have plenty of sugar so that they can annoy their parents and stay off the streets.
You Sam agent of chaos, you.
Shouts after them. Don't forget, build a snow fort and then attack the guards. See somewhere to retreat.
The one kid stops, turns around. No retreat! No corner! And then runs.
Someday I hope they become adventurers.
So I like their gumption.
James just blinks. Shall we continue then?
James, as you look back over your shoulder, as you guys start continuing on, you see Tom running and then just face plant into snow and he can't get himself up. He's like the kid from Christmas Story. Way too much padding on.
Can't put my arms down!
Riker will go ahead and go over and take hold.
The kids came back and helped him.
Okay.
Like I said, they're told they have to be nice to him. And they're pretty good kids.
Just picturing him dragging him by his foot so he can't fall over again.
So, you guys make it to this small kind of outpost. Less fort, more outpost. Correct that. The doors are currently open. There's a pair of two double doors. You see a couple horses hitched. Looks like there's a warm fire in, and there it looks like there's a guard up in the three story tower. And that sees you all in waves and points to the door down below.
All right. Riker will tip his hat respectfully towards the guard on the tower and head towards the door and lightly knock.
Yeah, he gives you a nod back as you hear, come on in!
Riker will open the door and step inside.
Yeah, very modest, kindly built residence. There looks like there's one foyer with a large fireplace seeming to be heating everything. Looks like there's a couple potentially either storerooms to one side. Maybe they're bunk rooms. You're not quite sure because the doors are closed. But there's one man seemingly sitting at the table. He's got blonde, wavy hair, clumsily hangs over a long, worried face. Small hazel eyes set rooted within their sockets, watching over the establishment. Some of you guys do have pretty good perception, so I'll just give you this. An arrow seems to have left a mark stretching from the top of his left cheek, running towards the right side of his lips, ending on the left nostril. Leaves a pleasant memory of a situation escaped. He looks over, please, make yourself at home, out of the cold. Join me. Long wooden table.
Riker will step forward and go to join at the table.
Physically glued to the fire. So warm.
Wrath will go behind the table and stand at attention.
James just right, joins Marcus. Right.
Continue. Sorry, James.
No, he's just going with Riker. Yeah.
So yeah, some of you making your way by the fire. Unless he goes, so what can I do for you?
We are representatives of the Burning Phoenix Guild, and they had a list that was looking for assistance involving green dragons posted by Captain Taylor Torrent, and we had come to respond to the bounty posting.
He nods. I'm Guard Captain Wilfer. I can give you as much as you guys need, but he kind of looks over and calls out, bring me Dickens! And looks back, gives you back his full attention.
Is his first name Chad?
No. So.
Is it Larry?
No. His first name is Dickens.
What's his last name?
My goodness.
He's lowborn. He's not gonna have a last name. Not everyone in the world has a last name.
Remember so he's Dickens here. Dickens?
He's just Dickens.
Yeah.
He goes, so, what I know of this is a number of caravans which should have arrived have not made it here. Now, whether they just simply encountered snow or decided not to come because of weather or anything else, that I am not sure. We also have seen a lack of travelers. I mean, normally you would see a few others kind of stopping in, get out of the cold before they make their way to Sheraton. Now, people apparently believe this to be of dragons, but, you know, there was a druid about 5 years ago who also covered the whole woodlands in thorny vines. So, whether this is the druid being upset, whether this is a dragon or whether this is all just someone covering for bandits, I don't know.
Do you happen to know the druid's name?
I have not met him.
Could you describe the druid?
I have not met him. I just simply know that there is a druid that is in to protect the ancient forest.
All right. I just figured that I would ask because maybe you had gotten heard stories of it.
He goes, you have to see, Cortia and Sheraton are not exactly always on the best of terms. Especially with the newer sort of carving out of countries. They have aligned themselves with Malbec instead of aligning themselves with us, so that druid tends to do more with Cortia than here.
Well, perhaps we'll be able to find out answers.
My just came back with a makeover. She got short,
I told
like
you, I cut my
she
hair
got a
and got
bob. She has nails
it's
painted.
Not
I'm sorry.
Bob, it's awesome.
She's
she needs to get on the camera.
No.
Come on.
Let us see ya. Trees here. Fireflies here.
Bend down.
It's amazing.
They like it.
Yeah, we got stuff around.
Okay, live. Thank you.
Oh.
She's all bothering and she's all happy. So, her and my mom went out and had a girl's day. Salon and everything. So.
It's needed every now and then.
That's why we'll come down to visit. So, what he goes on to tell you, he goes, as far as I know, you look point motions to you. What's your name? Looking G Riker. Since you were the one that had the first question.
Breaker Cursalian.
Mr. Cursalian, I believe something is going on. Alright? There's too many signs for it not, something not to happen. Because be it dragons or otherwise, it needs to be handled. I am not afraid of it coming to the city because we have an army. But for the people outside the city, the kids, the families, the travelers, that's where my problem is. Because I am one of five people that might be at this guard station. And if it's a dragon, I'll fight to protect him, but he kind of, like, motions. He's a, you know, he can see wrinkles of sad and he's, you know, probably in his late 30s. He goes, I'm the only one here with any real experience. He kind of smiles. So,
I certainly know that feeling, and I know the feeling of what it means and what it takes involving the reduction of travelers and also merchants, because I had helped Wildreach with their issues that similar circumstances, but it wasn't dragons that were stealing the supplies or attacking the travelers and merchants. But we will certainly look into it.
It's a city, right? Not a town.
No, it's a full, like, it's a massive city.
That would be.
Yeah, population over 20,000.
Have a teleportation circle?
He goes, yeah, to citizens, there is a couple teleportation circles, yes.
Oh, okay. No, just checking.
Most of the people teleport outside, similar to probably where you arrived from. And, you know, yeah. there was a stone circle they keep clean.
Okay, awesome. I was just because finding the way home. The the best way to put it is, upon people vanishing, is there like a set area where they're more likely to vanish than another area?
Because you'll have to ask Dickens. He's the scout. He'll be able to give you a better. He goes, because depending on the route they're taking, they could be in the forest for almost a week if they're going far north. It's a very expansive forest. About that time, the door creaks open, and black short haired hangs gently over a thin, radiant face. Shuttered brown eyes set bird within their sockets, watch admiringly over the families they protected. A tattoo resembling a small swallow is prominently featured on the left side of his eye, and that is Dickens. Kind of salutes the guard captain, who motions him to sit down. Dickens, these here are adventurers. Riker, and he motions towards you, Sam.
Sam nods.
Your name?
I'm Samantha.
Looks to Wrath.
Wrath.
Brian. And then finally to the bard.
He looks up from his writing. James.
These are going to take the bounty from Captain Torrent. He nods and looks to all of you and kind of gives you a smile. What can I be of assistance with?
We have just been asked in regards to disappearances, the caravans and travelers, and wondering if there's particular areas where they had taken place, whether or not there were any signs of scuffle or conflict, if there had been any survivors that had been in the area that might have seen what it was ending up taking place.
Mm-hmm. So, he goes, what I know is I haven't gone too deep in, but there's been a number of corpses picked clean in the woods, but I've not come across any real tracks. It was a passerby who reported directly to me that they saw a large winged green dragon in the area. That being why there's the thought of green dragons. From what I've seen, it's like the forest boogeyman has created labyrinths of thickets. Parts of the forest are hard to pass through, and even the rodents and birds are moving around oddly, almost if they're like searching for something.
Most curious on what they might be searching for.
And they're searching for those last four retweets to get you guys all a second natural 20.
I know.
Can animals retweet stuff?
If they sign up for Twitter, I mean, it's kind of the logo's kind of a bird, right?
Exactly.
No. I may have started signing up Buster and Dexter onto Twitter. Just saying.
This passerby that you came across, what did they look like?
Older man, was dirty, had some wounds, but never had seen him before.
Is there anything? Did you? So you said there were parts of the forest that were hard to move through. Did you go any further beyond just some difficult moving forest?
They're not normally there. Spent most of my life there.
Have you ever, in person, been able to meet the druid in charge of those woods?
Boogeyman? Nope. You realize, you look at him, give him a good look over. He's like 20 years old. So, 5 years ago, he would have been 15. Right? He goes, nope. Spent a couple months in that forest when those vines went up with no way to get out. So if I ever meet him, I'm going to run the hell away. Hope he put an arrow in his leg so I can outrun him.
Aim for the knee.
Sam looks at him. and gives him a hug and goes, "Don't worry, he's not that scary."
Kind of looks towards you with a raised eyebrow.
Anyways,
I know his brother. She just leave it at that. His brother. Now he's the scary one.
Anyways, so the witness said they saw a dragon. Did they say what direction it was flying in, or where, what area they saw it in?
That's what they told me. It's about a couple days in.
This is just a personal question, but I can't help but admire your tattoo. What does it mean?
Kind of touches it. All of them, the men of my family, were rangers, and they all had one just like it. It's kind of a family thing. Smiles. Needs to be the truth. Nothing more.
If there is a deeper meaning, he doesn't know if there is a deeper meaning. That's actually really interesting. She goes, "I have tattoos, but I can't show you in public."
James just blinks to that and just continues writing.
She grins.
So, they look and they go, "This is everything we have." Dickens kind of chimes in one more time. From what I've encountered, I'm sure this is a group of green dragons, but that's just a gut feeling. Because I've never encountered one. Ever.
Well, you fight one dragon, you know, stay away from the bitey end, or the gas expelling end, or fire expelling. Really, just stay away from either end.
He laughs and nods. Noted.
Most intelligent people would just stay away from dragons altogether, but...
We're adventurers, we're not exactly up there.
Deadwish is what I'd call it.
I like his idea. Stay away from altogether. Smiles. So.
Since you're originally from this area, anyway, and you out of a particular
cave. You're breaking up a little bit on me? It's on my end.
Caves.
Try one more time. You're breaking up. It's on my end.
Do you know of any air? Yeah. Does or regions in this area that dragons might call home?
He kind of. I mean, there's some rivers, and some little bit of marsh, in the forest. Kind of pulls out a map and shows you the general area. He goes, based on what I've heard, this would probably be it. There's an old ruined tower that used to be in the woods over there too.
What would it be to try and draw?
Dexterity.
Like the area that's on the map.
Sam's gonna.
You get a good enough sketch of the area.
Okay.
It's not gonna be completely accurate because you're not sure how accurate the distance is of this map.
Right, yeah.
But it gives you at least a general idea. And same.
Apart from the boogeyman, she grins at this, trying not to chuckle aloud. What should we avoid? Are there any things to be worried about? I mean, I know there are hags at one point.
Yeah, you're going off me. That's why he's replying. Sorry. What was your question? I was responding to the chat.
Is there anything else we should look out for to avoid? Any other creatures, or should we worry about the boogeyman?
Dire wolves, but you all look like you can handle some dire wolves and other such things. Apparently there was hags way back when, way up in the north, but not down here. But it's a forest, and, you know, anything can move in. So, You guys ready to head out?
Sure.
Would we need transportation, or on foot is the better option? If we need to be... not quite one for stealth myself, but... if we could ride upon horseback, would that be preferable? Wrath will say this to the group.
If we could get access to horses, it would certainly allow us to get through some of the open area quicker, but then we would end up having to still get to the area where the potential attacks have been taking place.
Well, if horses are needed, I can potentially procure some.
And when it comes down to stealth, I can help with that.
Wrath will clink the chain armor.
Got to keep oneself protected. Does have a disadvantage when it comes to being sneaky. But if you're able to manage that, it would be great help.
I can make sure we leave no tracks, make no sound, that kind of thing.
Okay, so. Wilfred would tell you you'd have to go all the way to the city to get horses. They got like two outside, and there's five of you.
Could I use my military rank feature from soldier background to get the horses, like give him, like get him to like give a note that we could get these horses for free?
He would tell you that he wouldn't mind even without using the rank. More along the lines that you guys are helping them out.
Okay, fair enough. Person
is. He just says that, you know, it depends on, you know, where they are, and you'll have to deal with other people. He goes, I'm willing to write it if you need it. But that's just kind of a, you know, you're gonna spend a lot of time waiting based on where you have to go.
Sam will look at Rash and go, look, one, they're gonna need the horses. There's only two of them, and if there's an emergency, they're gonna have to get out quick. If there is a bunch of dragons going towards the city, these guys have to get to the city quicker than the dragons. So the horses will be needed. Plus, I mean, where we're going with the horses, one bad branch or route, and the horse trips and falls, it could hurt itself. And really, what good is a lame horse?
You make a fair point. I was simply suggesting that we'd have a ride to the forest, and then if we need to make a hasty escape. I wasn't going to take their two horses. No, that would not do.
He was just wanting a referral letter.
Yeah, that's basically all I was asking.
Dickens looks towards you. You'd have to leave him once you encountered the brambles anyways.
Yeah. But if we are not in need of them, then we can move forward.
So if you guys are ready to move forward, you guys exit out of the small outpost. They wish you good luck. By the time you get there, you would have been approaching noon, they would have actually fed you. So you guys get a free meal. They share what they have with you. And you kind of head out, following the road into, and we're going to do this quicker. You know, you guys spend 2 days worth of rations for food. You guys have your spells back if you used any, but you hadn't. And you guys head into the actual forest itself. You get about, I would say, a half day into the forest before there's a weird beeping noise.
My apologies. I had to turn a fan on.
That's okay.
Before we get too far in, Sev, Sam will be on the lookout for tracks. Okay. She'll be moving quietly. Also something to state. And, if she sees tracks, just, you know.
Okay, well, you need to roll for things that you want to find.
She'll be trying to track the dragons, if there are any dragons.
We're past friendly NPCs who want you guys to deal with things, so you don't have to roll social stuff on NPCs that want you to help. surprisingly a lack of tracks, actually. To the point where there should be more tracks.
Like animal tracks, it's, or just...
It's, yeah, they're not even really big animal tracks. You're only seeing small creatures' tracks.
Well, I mean, it's understandable. This forest has been burnt down twice now. Big things might avoid coming here.
So, you guys get about a half day into the forest before you guys spot basically what Dickens had told you you'd see. There is these brambled thickets kind of grown in between trees and very hard to pass. But it's almost like you're at a labyrinth.
What, we're almost like we're in a wet sieve?
It's almost like you're in a labyrinth and there's a path.
Can I check if these are natural?
Mm-hmm, you can. Well, Arcana.
Or Arcana, okay.
They're not magical. That would be how you're going to check your real. Rolling in an Arcana check.
Really, but that... The way they're formed, like the labyrinth kind of thing, that's not natural.
It's definitely not a natural growing pattern, I'll give you that. It's almost like something is specifically done this.
Would this be indicative of a green dragon? Since they're kind of clever and tricky?
You can roll me a history check.
Cool.
You've heard of them being the clever, tricky type. You've heard of them when they make nests in somewhere, being able to, like all dragons, shape the area around them, the surrounding miles. So, I mean, while you're not quite sure that this is what green dragons do specifically, based on your history check, you can be pretty certain that this would at least follow that narrative of what you're thinking.
Okay.
It's definitely not ruling out your thought.
I'll relay this as like a rumor to the party.
Breaker will look to Sam and Brienne because they're specialists in dragon hunting. He would ask them if that sounded reasonable or unreasonable.
Yes.
So, you were asked a question?
Yeah. I asked if I needed to roll anything.
You would.
What do I need to roll?
It'd be a nature.
Nature.
The bonus.
I get advantage. Yep. Not. Oh God, I'm not proficient in nature. 11.
Again, it kind of makes sense. You're in that with Wrath, where it's definitely not, this definitely isn't ruling dragons out or green dragons, but you're just not sure that this is what they do.
Can I make?
Yeah.
Nature or history?
Nature, because you get advantage. Again, all of you.
All three of us are standing there just nodding our heads going, yeah.
Yeah, sounds about right.
Can I try, Sev?
Sure.
Because why not?
I'm gonna laugh.
On a 16, you were also nodding here. Yeah, no, that makes sense.
So I rolled the best out of all of you.
I just picked these large thicketed vines. Thorns coming out. There's like this little hole they can climb through. They're all like, form up a circle, and the dragons. Dragons. Just all nodding at each other. Like, yeah, good. Yeah, thank you, Professor. And yes. Great point. We'll definitely have to go ahead and, complete our thesis on if this is green dragons or not.
Oh God, Sam! No, not science class, please.
With that being said, Sev, I would like to use my primeval awareness.
Okay.
I spend a spell slot, and if there's a dragon within a mile, I'll share it.
Within a mile?
Mm-hmm.
Nope. I'm pretty sure you should read the second part of it.
Yeah, I know.
This is not your favorite terrain, forest?
No, it's not. I've got mountains and desert. Because, you know, away from...
Yeah, but Sam wasn't in the desert.
No, but it was next to the mountains. I was like, eh, that makes sense.
So, you guys heading in to the labyrinth?
I mean...
I'll cast Pass Without Trace on the group.
Okay, second spell slot down.
Yep.
Shall we do this quietly then?
Please.
Perhaps. We don't want to draw any unneeded attention.
Quietly.
Unless we draw the attention of the dragon, then we don't have to look for it.
You know, he's not exactly wrong there, but still... but still, hiding is probably best.
Alright, who's going in first?
Not it.
I like how this is probably the actual... What's our marching order? Not it. James just backs up.
I imagine it would probably end up being Brienne, Wrath, James.
I can go first, but when she hits the fan, I'm moving to the back. I'm just saying.
Okay.
Are you sure about this?
Sam, roll that stealth.
Yeah, I'm moving at half speed also, even with the Cloak of Elvenkind, Sev.
So that's... Roman and acrobatics.
Acrobatics?
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
Sam vanishes into the thorns. Who's next?
Whee!
Was it right at the same
hour? Yeah, I will. I'll go.
Alright, stealth. 30, not bad. And now in acrobatics.
Oh, God.
Bran vanishes into the, to the thicket. Wrath, I think you were next.
Yep.
That's a disadvantage, right?
Huh? Disadvantage, yes. So
that's
15.
A 15. Yeah, still not bad. And in acrobatics.
Is there a way that it could be athletics as opposed to acrobatics?
If you're just trying to charge through and break them all down.
I mean,
it's there. Kind of negates
your
stealth.
Wrath has no subtlety.
Kind of negates the stealth, though.
Oh, that is also fair. Oh, okay, then.
Because it's like a rah! It just runs in. All right.
Oh.
So Wrath disappears into the thickets.
God damn it.
Who's next? James or Riker?
You're not really good
James.
Right now.
James just looks to Riker as all this happens. I get the feeling we're already been seen. How about you?
I get the feeling we're getting there.
Yeah. Alright, see you on the other side, but he pats him on the shoulder and goes in.
Okay. Romeo stealth and we have to connect really quick. One second. Disconnected. Are we back up?
Nope.
Stream, are we back up? We should be just.
No, we're not. Like
I'm glad
we're not back.
How about now?
So, hold on. It's loading.
It's loading. Loading.
It's loading. Hold on. I'm going to reload the entire screen.
There we go. It's up.
All right. Yeah. All right.
So, James enters in to the into the thickets. James, as you disappear from Riker's side, you see Wrath upside down, caught in vines. You're not quite sure how he got stuck there.
A little help, please.
Where's Sam? Sorry, I have to ask.
You don't see Sam yet.
Oh my god.
I look around for the others.
You don't see them yet. He didn't make it very far with the two, man.
I I looked at him and just like, so I can just send you out with my rapier. Wait, no, that's a piercing weapon.
The ranker, roll me yours as you, as James.
And dropped again.
Dropped again, Sev.
Alright, well, we have a recording, so we'll keep playing. We're gonna have to just. You have to come in as they come.
Back up again, Sev.
Sev! Stop. Just stop.
I'm doing something very dangerous right now. I have soup.
So, what are you, Jim? I need Riker's rules.
Okay. Lord.
35 and 11. So, Riker starts making it in. You see Wrath upside down as James is trying to cut a bunch of vines away with a piercing weapon. Wrath, you may die of old age.
This will work.
I'm not getting any younger.
This will work. Just wait. Just you wait.
Riker, you see both of them.
Riker tilts his head, draws his longsword, and he will help James to free Wrath.
Oh, yeah. Longsword, you're out in like 10 seconds. Once you get slashed with it.
See, I did it.
You know, I had longsword at my side and greatsword on back you could have used.
Why didn't you tell me? See, communication.
I was waiting to see your...
Communication is important, buddy. Now you'll learn for next time.
I thought perception was better.
He just keeps going. He just keeps going.
Alright, you just keep going. So, you make it another about 10, 15 feet in. And you see Brienne literally caught in almost like an identical position, but she's right side up. She's not quite sure. She probably went up when she should have gone down.
Do you have a slashing weapon? Where is it?
It's on her back.
Can I grab it, Sev? Use it.
It's a glaive. It's really heavy.
Could I just use my longsword?
Yeah. He starts trying to climb up and get the glaive off her back. And Riker and Wrath, both of the longswords out, just walk up. Describe how you feel.
See, I did it again. He just walks. He just keeps going. See, I did it. He just keeps going.
Wrath will turn to Riker.
Are they always like this?
Riker pauses a moment, looking deep in thought. And nods.
Fair enough.
So, once you free Brienne and the three of you, James, you finally come upon Sam, who is sitting on a rock on the other side of the thorns, meeting the DC 10 acrobatics check. Did we lose you?
did Sam have any cookies left? Is she just sitting there eating?
Totally eating cookies. Yeah.
Just watching. What took you guys so long?
I had to free these two.
Why do I not believe that? And she just continues to eat her cookies.
I mean, I'm a trustworthy person.
I like it how it's you freed them. How the other three come out of the forest hearing this?
We all freed them, you know, like, he puts his arm around the two as a group.
He's taking credit for your work, isn't he?
I am not.
Meanwhile, Riker and Wrath have their long swords out, and James has a rape.
Yeah, so. Oh, man. The internet is not holding up. Yeah, I'm not getting all the voice. I'm getting red. Give me one second, guys, as you kind of RP. Give me a second, see if what's going on with internet. Give me just a moment.
Okay, I did not do such a thing. How dare you think that of me?
Totally did.
I did not do such a thing, and you can look straight into my eyes and say that.
No, you're dressed as a jester. Jesters creep me out, so no,
I'm
okay.
I'm not dressed as a jester.
So you're dressed as a clown then, gotcha.
I'm not dressed as a... I'm dressed as a bard. Because I'm a bard.
What's the difference?
A lot of things, actually.
Shots fired. Have you met Finn?
I have, actually.
Yeah, he's a clown.
Him and... I believe it was your sister. They got into a bit of a scuffle.
Ah, yes, yes.
Very entertaining to watch. Finn needs to watch when he drinks. Very early in the morning. Does not make for a good... personable fellow.
Ugh, Finn.
My hair is... But no, so we're just gonna sit here, eat cookies, stares at stream.
Hello there, the fourth wall.
Nelsie Man says, clown!
So, see, chat has spoken.
Quiet, it's Sam.
You're not. Josh.
I'm just curious on if James juggles or not.
My daughter may have been downloading movies on her iPod.
No.
So.
Wave. The voice from the sky.
The voice from the sky comes back.
So. I thought I took my meds.
As you guys continue on, I'm not sure how long either it's going to hold out. We're having some trouble right now. As the you guys head further in, you guys come upon looks to be the size of like a large creature. It's picked pretty much completely clean.
I would like to check for tracks.
You can certainly check for tracks, Miss Ranger.
I try and see what animal this was.
Sure.
Nature as well.
Yeah, nature. You see a lot of small. Kind of clawed tracks, but nothing big.
Sam. But they're claw tracks. Like, are they dragon tracks?
Yeah, you would know that they're probably like wormling tracks.
So there's Sam will look around. There's baby ones afoot.
Oh dear, that's not good.
It's definitely an animal. Yeah.
Oh, you know, I didn't know, Steph. Thank you.
Just because I have one.
It could have been a monstrosity or anything else.
Fair enough, yeah.
Definitely some sort of beast. Can't tell. Anyone else like to take a look in? A look-see?
Sure, why not? With my plus zero.
I'll take a look also.
You have dishonored my father.
Yeah, that's sorry, just zero. What
Nasi said.
Tree, you nod with the other three. Riker, you look.
Yeah,
right. Riker and Rath, you look at the other three. Like, yeah, it's definitely some sort of beast. Definitely a beast. The other two of you look and... Dude, it was an elk. So it's still got,
it was
still
a beast.
It still has the antlers there and everything. Yeah, it was an elk.
Woo, antlers. Can I try to harvest them?
Sure. You put your foot on and snap them in half.
Eh. I can still throw the broken bits at people.
Just gonna breathe.
I'm not getting desync on the actual thing now, so that's what's troubling me. I gotta figure out where the desync's happening from. Maybe if I do this. Any better, Nasi? Alright. Trying to fix the desync with everything. As we get there, so you guys move on, and as you're getting towards the area, the rodents and birds are, you know, around you, and they are watching you. Definitely watching you.
The birds are watching.
Mm-hmm.
Twitter striking back, guys. No, are they, like, creepy, or is it, like, protective? Like, what kind of watching?
They're following you like they're on the hunt.
Huh.
That's never a good sign.
Can I make an arcana check on that?
To make an arcana check on anything. So, yes.
God damn it.
So on your probably terrible roll.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Nah, dude, no magic involved whatsoever.
Sam looks towards the the bard and hisses. That's not magical, right? No, that's not magical.
I'll do my own check. If he's implying, I'll check myself.
Nah,
definitely not magical. Looks to Wrath, right? Definitely not magical.
You know, Paladin, you don't sense anything weird, do you?
Nope. Looks like animals to me. I won't even bother with a check. Not in his forte.
So, you guys make your way, as you guys make your way towards, so I'd like everyone to roll me a perception check.
So, sue me. I didn't take proficiency in perception. Knock that kind of ranger.
Consider it done. You're a suit.
Damn.
Just setting this up. Okay. So. As you guys approach, Bran, James, and Wrath, there's a tearing of flesh sound, and small, unable to hear the words, but you would recognize it as Draconic if you speak Draconic, seemingly yep. Chat going on just to, maybe 50 feet or less. To the west of you.
Do you point this out?
Brienne just kind of holds her arm out and kind of points toward the sound. And she says, I hear Trick.
I would like to stealth.
You're already in stealth.
Oh, okay.
That's the reason I haven't seen you.
Oh, I see.
Does the draconic sound humanoid or guttural?
Sounds like their mouth is full.
Can I make out what they're saying?
No, it's you can hear it, but it's just the words are too. Even if you're up close, you probably wouldn't be able to understand what they're saying. It's kind of that.
Too full.
Chewing with your mouth full.
Too full of food.
Yeah.
So, Sam's gonna. Oh, I don't want to do it now. Sam's gonna take out her bow and look to the others.
James gives a nod.
Rian's gonna pull her glaive.
Pulls out of the rapiers.
Pull the longsword.
Riker will ready his bow.
She will gesture to the three of them and then point ahead. And,
Three as in the three frontliners, yeah.
She then pauses a minute and uses an armor and kind of say, wait back.
So. Who's moving forward? Hey, Almeric. Welcome, man. Welcome back. Who's moving forward?
Sam will move forward, I guess.
All right, Sam, as you step forward, concentration leaves your mind. Roll me stealth. Yeah. Not even footstep sound. Just...
Are you moving? She blinks. She knows concentration is left.
Hmm?
Right?
Yeah.
Can she make an arcana to see if this is anti-magic, or...?
You can make it normal to go along the lines of, hey, it's been about an hour.
Ah, right, yeah.
It's probably just nice and let you guys enter the map with it up. Some might say.
Yeah. she's going to pause and look back.
Hear a little bit of rustling of chains.
Yeah, she's like, should I cast it again? Should I not cast it again? No, because it has verbal components as well. She's got a chance at...
You casting it again or no?
She's going to step back. No, she can't. No, not being this close to battle. So she's going to move forward towards the nearby tree.
Anyone else moving?
Yeah.
Okay.
Roll that stealth, Brienne.
This is going so badly. Ooh!
Creeps up. Sam, you can also see it looks like a large, like a giant elk. It's kind of like hind that's getting moved around.
So, clearly it's dead, but it's been eaten.
Yes, something is having a snack.
She's gonna circle around to the next tree. Okay. She's moving like slow and low.
All right, go ahead and roll me another stealth every time you move. My turn, Sam.
You know what? I'm gonna use my advantage.
Okay. Sam dives into the bushes without a sound. A single leaf falls to the ground. Brienne, you doing anything?
Pops out.
Brienne blinks at the sudden disappearance of Sam. And she is going to continue to stealth forward.
Roll that stealth.
Oh, God. Oh,
Sam, all the heads snap as you get a better view. Two of these heads snap and look, seeing Brienne. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is that time of the evening when we roll initiative.
Do I get a surprise round?
You do not, because they just... And they popped up. You will be already hidden.
Okay. I can live with that.
Thanks for the nat 20 now, game.
And everyone?
Yep.
Right. Could I use the advantage?
You have to call it before you roll.
Before the roll? Okay.
Sorry, you're new. I forget to explain that to you. Yeah. Or the nat 20, you always call it before you roll.
Fair.
This way you're not like, oh, now I want to use it for sure. Like, yeah. It's still that element of... Dun, dun, dun. All right, so... That is... Riker, it is your turn. You do not technically see it.
Alrighty.
But you can hear everything stop, and you see Brienne's eyes kind of go wide. She reaches for her pole arm.
Alright. Riker is going to... Is he still basically hidden because he hadn't moved?
You are hidden in terms of the fact they don't know you're there yet.
Okay.
But you don't have a line of sight on them, so it's like you could...
Yep. Riker is going to hold action because he basically doesn't know what's going on or why Brienne had stopped the way that she did, but just since she's going for a weapon, I will hold turn until something ends up changing.
So
especially
Brienne
if there's something threatening.
The
I will wait until after the wormlings.
James.
I.
Me and Brienne would, like, kick a rock and go, ow, my foot! Oh, shit.
James just, like, slowly face bumps into that, but, like.
Yeah, that's your job to break stuff.
Exactly! I remember that. You remember that? I remember that.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, followers of all ages, that's 20 retweets. You all have a second natural 20.
Dope, thank you guys.
Okay, that'll be next.
Now at
yeah.
30, someone might get items. Or
yeah.
Maybe we add them another enemy on thing. Whatever your chat wants.
Wait. Another enemy? That's a possibility?
Wait, whatever
it
chat wants.
Chat wants?
Whatever chat wants.
Guys, please get those 10 things in so you can add an ancient green dragon.
I mean, I can do it right now.
Please. Terrifying, truly.
Okay. I'm just going to give you a heads up, Bio. Never make side comments like that around Seb.
Never make
side comments.
I made a side comment like that with Seb around. And he wasn't even DMing, and we thought we were joking about.
Oh gosh. Okay. Noted.
I mean, if you want dragons, I mean, I feel like I should be exhibit right now. I heard you like dragons, so let's add some dragons to the initiative. There you go.
Oh no.
Oh gosh.
It was gonna come in after round one. There we go. Now you know where it is. James.
Okay. Yeah, well, I don't even know this thing exists yet, so.
Here, James. Here, I got you. I get you, boo.
Yo, you got me? Oh, now I know it exists. And everyone, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.
Does my passive hear the bard soil their pants?
Alright.
What's your passive?
12 or something?
No.
I have a 24.
Right here.
Oh Lord.
I'm gonna go right here and I'm gonna hold my action for when or it slash if one of these wormlings get within rapier range.
Okay.
Brain just steps to the side.
No, she doesn't. Let's see. What is its passive? Oh, it's definitely not higher than. So this thing's got some movement speed. And there's a bard! It likes bards.
It likes bards.
Wait.
Do I get my
glide down? You do get your yell before it hits anything. As it kind of glides down. It's like those.
Hey, Sev?
Yes.
Was I skipped?
And I do have a question. You're sick, bud. And I do have a question.
Why is it all messed up? Hold on a second.
Because Riker moved down.
No, right, yeah, Riker moved down. So you still are at the bottom. Riker's held his turn. James is the first one to technically act.
Oh, okay.
I do have a question about my maneuvers. If I hold my action, can I still use one of my maneuvers?
What does it say? It's a bonus action.
It's not a bonus action. It's
then
a part of my attack. Okay. So I'll use my maneuver then. So two main hands. That's a miss, and that's
a miss.
It doesn't state if I have to hit or not though.
What maneuver are you trying to use?
Defensive.
Which is, just link the defensive. Link the whole text for me, please.
Okay. There we go.
I meant just the defensive. You should really, really separate these out.
I will.
This is terrible. You can spend 1 minute extra damage to the target you hit.
Okay, I hit. Okay. Alright, fair enough.
So. It, it's there.
Yes.
And it's gonna go ahead and go, huh. I mean, that would be mean. So it's totally gonna do it. Brianne and James.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a pair of Constitution saving throws. As it breathes in this, the chest expanding and just exhales this poison gas. You both will pass, so you will take half.
Nods.
So you'll take 24 points of poison damage that slams down, landing in the river right there. And it just looks towards you. Just gaping mouth. Looking quite hungry. Brianne!
Some pretty bad breath, bud.
Riker, I'd let you go before the worm moves if you'd like to, because of change.
Riker. Riker will go ahead and go.
I'll have you go after Brianne.
Okay. Brianne. Yeah.
Brianne can attack him from where she is.
You're gonna attack?
Yeah.
Alright, Dragon Slayer, let's see you do it.
Okay. I'm not gonna Great Weapon Master.
That is a 13. Miss. That will hit. The first glaive kind of, it just kind of slides out of the way. The second one on the pullbacks when you actually catch and pull some scales off, blood splattering into the river for 15 points of damage.
And then... That's my turn.
Alright, Riker.
Alrighty. Riker will utilize his longbow and the fact that nothing presently knows that he is where he is, and he will take two shots at it.
I think it was like in the 30s, wasn't it? Or in the high 20s.
Okay, if it was that high, then yeah, fine.
Yeah, it was a 35.
They'll be at advantage, but then you will be revealed.
Yep. And I will use my sneak attack.
Okay.
Yay for all of that.
24s, both will hit. So from the bush, Riker pulls out two arrows as that is 30...
40.
Is it 40 even? Yeah. 40 even. Two arrows impacting into this thing's chest. Just almost in this guttural roar. Looking at, and it's definitely seen you now.
Yep.
Anything else, Riker?
That will be it for now.
Zeldrick, thank you for the follow. Alright, Wyrmling's turn. They totally just fly over Sam because she's hidden. Two. Three. Four. Uncover more of this map for you guys. Let's see.
That's a massive elk.
Yeah, that's the size of a giant elk. Remember Bogo being one?
No, we managed to get him up to, was it gigantic?
Yes, because we kept doing enlarge, yeah. We gave him enlarge in haste as a giant elk.
Oh, that's why there was a giant elk at one time.
Yeah. That sounds nasty.
It was fun. It was a lot of fun. So, James and Brian, you're each going to take two attacks at advantage.
All right.
So, James, you first.
Yep, both
22 and 12.
12 misses.
So you'll take a total of 9 points of damage. This little thing, because you're looking up at the big, the larger dragon kind of sitting there bleeding. Two arrows and it's got these two just kind of swarm around you. And, one gets a good bite into your shoulder. Brianne.
Yep.
An 11 and a 14.
The 14 hits. It meets.
So that is 13 points of damage for you. As again, the swarming around you just kind of get a bite off. That will be the Wyrmling's turns. That will take us to Sam. Who is still perfectly
okay.
Hidden. Yeah, D&D party.
So Sam's going to take two shots. One at the wormling that's closest to the dragon, and then one just at the one below it.
Okay, you know, so you're taking two shots, different targets.
Yeah. Would I be at advantage for both shots?
You are advantage for both shots because you already hit him. Especially with that nat 20.
So,
Twenty-one totally.
So I get sneak attack on that.
You do. You have allies within 5 feet, and you're hidden. So 23 and 29 damage as Sam pops out of the bush, drawing the arrow just right in, almost crippling it. Right, just missing the spine where you would have one shot.
Oh, disappointed now. I should have dumped my bonus action thing.
The second one, you just kind of, as it's flying around, you just catch just the wrong angle with the arrow as it bounces off the scales. Thank you for the follow as well, Killer Plug. Yeah, we play a lot of D&D. Streams have been out of sync. We're not home, but we're trying to get things fixed for travel. But we play for like 14 games a week.
And that's my turn.
Okay. Nothing as a bonus?
I can't re-stealth, and all my bonus no actions one. Are either.
Gotcha. Raph!
Yeah.
Oh, goodness.
First turn officially in combat here in Pharrell.
Wrath will throw up his right hand, and the tattoos will begin to glow. He's going to point at the big dragon. I'm going to Hexblade curse him.
Oh, we get a Hexblade. I hear Hexblade. Okay, Hexblade's curse.
There it is. Then I'm going to run up to him. It's movement, and then action. Swing the two-handed longsword.
Okay. That is a hit, good sir.
That would be a crit as well, because it's 19, right?
You have to have a 19 on the die. So if you were at advantage, you'd have been off. So that is not a crit.
It's 18 on.
Yeah, it's an 18. If you had advantage, but you do not have advantage. You play true flanking.
Fair.
I'm going to give you the higher of the two numbers, but you also have that bonus damage from the Hexblade's curse. Just since you have be nice.
Yep.
And the bonus, what's the bonus damage?
The D10 plus.
It's only. Oh, it's already in there?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Plus.
Okay,
sweet. I got you. It's the plus three, and then yep. From it being yep. My weapon,
sure
I chose.
Everything out. All right. Okay, and then this. Anything else around the game? We lost internet. So, this is the point where I say. We need a new router for this house. I smile, and I wait for everything to reattach. Because it will, but we're just gonna have to wait a little bit. The internet goes down. So, we have a red box, it's me and you. We'll be back in a moment here. We're just gonna wait for everything to reconnect. Testing. So, we should have this all back to being connected. Testing 1, 2, 3. Are we not on Discord? Alright, Discord. 1 second, guys, ladies and gentlemen. Just trying to get everything back up. Hello!
Welcome back.
Hi.
Hi.
I need really to buy my mom that new router. It happens all the time. Like the third or fourth
I'm picturing you kind of staring at this router going, I will put you in a microwave if you don't work.
Okay. So, I was asking, there's the second attack. By all means, a 17 just misses, unfortunately.
Oh, just misses? Oh.
Just misses by one. They're hardy dragons, they are. Anything else, you've already done your bonus, movement, and action. So, that'll bring us back to the top of the round with Mr. James. Are we back up on stream? I cannot see.
No, we're not.
We are not on stream.
Do you want me to wait?
I would like you to wait. I'm going to stop stream and start stream. I can do that. I'm going to keep the recording. I don't edit. I do the video editing for YouTube, so this is all there. You get to hear me talk to you guys, like the shit you don't hear, as I just talk. Anyway, we don't have this? Alright, I may actually stop the recording and restart.
Really?
Yeah, I'm not. If it's not coming up.
Due to OBS?
Yeah, if OBS goes. What do you have is currently on. Well, that doesn't help me.
That doesn't help me.
All right.